actually happened in Philadelphia. Where's the baseline from which we have to operate going forward? So to have a conversation about economic development, failed two cities here in Philadelphia. The Pew Research Center's done a report basically shows that if you look at Philadelphia, the population has increased. If you look at the population by virtue of race, the racial composition has not changed for African Americans. Same number of blacks, except for they're concentrated in different areas. The areas in which they are concentrated in have the real estate that has not grown as quickly as the real estate areas in which African Americans do not live. Traditionally, more areas in which there's a concentration of African Americans over here, but you can see the rental receipts change in how much they were charged rent has not gone up. It's about one tenth of what happens in a neighborhood where we are not concentrated as the owners of the property. Long-term socioeconomic barriers to wealth parity have been in place for a very long time. So I think I see Brother Keith Ellison here. I think of the Urban League uses the symbol of the equal sign as its symbol. Equal is not fair. Often we say things are not fair. I heard somebody in the video, I think the brother's name is Barry Jones, say he wanted equality, equal opportunity, right? But what has happened? We have wealth transfer issues. These sometimes evade people's understanding because we don't really have wealth, we don't understand what these issues are. But the first one says lower inheritance rates. If you're African American, you live in the United States of America, you're more likely not to have inheritance. Everybody starts at zero. Whereas if you're not African American, you generally inherit more and you inherit larger amounts. So in other words, it's a 100-yard dash, but you start 15 yards behind the start line. Number two, lower state taxes. State taxes don't even hit the vast majority of Americans, but what they do is when you lower them, it allows for the wealth to remain exactly in the same family hands as it always had. So when you lower the estate tax, what happens is wealth is concentrated and remains concentrated over generations. And so that also contributes to wealth disparity. Number three, you have to own assets, which is real estate, stocks, in order for capital gains to even matter to you. And so for us, the idea of owning that those assets is lower for housing, lower for stocks. And so they don't impact us, but they concentrate the wealth away from everything.
I'm finding so many different mentalities today. It seems challenging. I don't say hard because the only thing hard is the concrete that you walk on. Everything else is